1970, I was elected as chief, and I knew that I would be able to promote sports and recreation for the band. And we didn't have no recreational dollars, so I had to pursue the various departments to try and obtain dollars from them, the federal department as well as the province. The province were never really wanting to get involved at the reserve level. They had recreational programs, but they were for the towns, villages, cities, and everything, and they excluded the reserve. The excuse that they always had was, well, you have the federal government to look after your people. And I didn't really accept that. When I was planning to go into a full-time recreation, I said, I'm going to take this province to task. I said, and I'm going to approach them and ask them for funding as a resident of Saskatchewan, not as a federal responsibility. They didn't like that, but I marched on them. I took the whole band here, and I marched into Regina here with my band, and they finally accepted the idea that they had to include all the bands in Saskatchewan for whatever programs that they had. And they used to have summer games and winter games, the province, provincial games they used to call them. And Indian athletes were never involved, because we had no facilities to practice our athletes. But after we started getting organized and everything else like that, and then they started noticing that we did have good athletes as well.
My name is Howard Walker. The elders called me Maskopmote, Bear Walker, my spiritual name. The lance run historically was done by scouts that went and looked for places for camps to winter, for seasonal camps, if you will. And they went ahead and they had this lance for identity. In some places that lance was honored, that this man that carried that lance was to be spared and was to be helped in any way possible. But there were differences in tribes where lance keepers, lance runners, did not make it home. In order for me to get to give you the most exact purpose and spirit and intent of that lance, I had to go to elders, I had to offer them tobacco and say, Moshum, tell me, what is this about? To be able to go into unfamiliar territory, familiarize yourself, and to live comfortably in that territory. That was the main teaching of the lance. And it was dormant for a long, long time, since the time that our ceremonies had to go underground, so did the lance. And it wasn't until 1996 when a chief, Barry Ahenikew, had asked for a lance to be bought to his reserve from Poundmaker. Chief Douglas Joseph at the time from Big River had commissioned an elder, a medicine man from Sturgeon Lake by the name of Senator Hilliard Ermine, to make that lance. This man had a vision of that lance. The lance keeper of Attakacope said, there's a rock in the front, and that was sharpened to make things easier. And the fur that was wrapped around that wood represents the four-legged. And in order for everything to be involved in that lance, they put four eagle feathers, one from each direction, and that was to get to involve the ones that fly. And the ones that fly, the eagle feather is a messenger of the thunderbird. The thunderbird looks after the water. So the water is involved in that lance through that eagle feather. So are the grandfathers. That lance has, even in contemporary times, has powers that sometimes unexplainable, that if you're not aware of your spirituality. The lance represents life. It represents the life, and it represents achievement of those capabilities that our children have. When you hold that lance, you feel different. When you hold that lance, when you're running down the road with that lance, domestic animals you pass by will gallop along, the horses will gallop along, and even the cattle will, and the birds will fly with you for a while. harness that with the courage of our leaders. The leaders like Tony Cody that envisioned this for a long ways so that our young people will have something to lean on, that legacy that we bring back.
My name's Teron Okney. I'm really honored to carry the lance. It's important because it's like it's a spirit inside that stick. It's like carrying in, like a elder, like actually holding someone very, very old. When I was tired and hot, it made me like it kind of regenerated me to run faster and keep going. And I just kept running because I'm doing it for my family and everybody who passed on.
Well, in the olden days, the way they used to do it, the Indian people, to keep their people in shape was there was no transportation or anything, and they would always have these races, and that's how they trained their the people that would contact the other bands from across the nations. They would have to be runners. They called them runners to pass a message to the next band and to the next band, and so they would, that's how they would get their best runners, whoever were the best runners were the ones that were the messengers to the bands right across the province, and as far as, and for that matter, into other provinces. That was their way of communication. They couldn't write, they couldn't read, no telephone, no nothing, so it is all verbal by mouth.
Morning, cousin.
Hey, cousin. Looking tired today?
Yeah, I was up all night, you know, doing my resume and stuff, trying to find a job.
Oh, yes. This came for you the other day. Or like 14 other days ago. Been meaning to get it to you. What does it say?
I just got a job as a reporter.
Really?
Yeah.
What are you reporting on?
It's at the Summer Games. I've been waiting for this for a while, and wow. This is awesome.
When do you start?
It says tomorrow.
I missed the bus!
Thank you.
Campbell, Beardies and Okamosis. I am the honorary athlete. I'll be carrying the flag in the opening ceremony. I was in summer games 2 years ago playing soccer. I was going to join an archery, but I can't right now because I'm fighting leukemia. So thought I'd come and cheer on my team.
I was so happy when I heard that they wanted her to be an honorary athlete. Since she has been fighting her leukemia, there was a lot of things she couldn't participate in, and due to the doctor's order, she couldn't really participate in summer games, so I'm happy she gets to experience this year. I know she can beat it. She's doing so good. We've been going for treatments multiple times a week. It's scary, but with all the help, support, and the prayers from the community and everyone, I know she's well taken care of. And a big thank you to Saskatoon Cancer Clinic. They've been a huge support for her.
I'm just really glad they chose me. I feel really honored.
Marv Sanderson, the person in charge, I know him pretty well, and they wanted to do something for the volunteers, and we came up with a $5,000, actually two $2,500 shopping sprees.
Sarah, have you seen the England samples anywhere?
Two lucky volunteers are going to win it, and they can come and hopefully fill up their house with a bunch of new stuff. There's a lot of Aboriginal communities within and around PA. We do a lot of work with different bands. Leon's Prince Albert is, of course, very proud to be part of it. I'm going to help out at the canoeing event, and my daughter's going to come, and my brother's doing some stuff. So just on the volunteer side, we're going to be involved as well.
So you're here right now. You go back out to the street here. You take a right.
I want to thank every volunteer that put their name in and showed up for their positions, because without them, we would not be able to do this. Simple as that. I mean, the games would have folded this morning if they hadn't shown up. And I want to thank all of them.
We set up our camp, some tents. And yeah, it's going good so far. My mom picked us up some KFC last night. Had a good breakfast.
Well, but competing practices.
Dad, when do we play our game?
What sport are you playing in this week?
Soccer.
Soccer? What position do you play in soccer?
Usually a forward.
Yeah? Okay.
Good luck to all the athletes.
Do you girls want to stand behind her? Yeah. Don't be shy. Girls are all beautiful. Tell me, what are you here for?
Chaperoning and helping coaching.
So have you ever participated in the summer games when you were younger?
Yep.
What did you play?
Soccer, ball, track.
All right, great ball.
Bill Gross, and I'm the manager of sport development and marketing for Golf Saskatchewan. Coming to Cook's always nice because they got such a beautiful golf course and facility, and people seem to really get behind the event and support Aboriginal youth development. This event's all about the kids, and seemed like they had a really good time out on the golf course competing. And the format that we're playing is a Texas Scramble Stableford format, and it gives kids with a wide range of skill levels the opportunity to compete in a fun atmosphere.
Camelia Muswa from BATC.
Desne Sittle from Musiman, BATC.
It was your first time golfing ever, right?
Yeah.
So what was it like competing in a competition like this for you?
Something new, learning more and more, but I'm getting the hang of it so far.
And what about for you? How was it like competing again for you?
It was exciting. I was nervous at first, but after the second hole, it was fun.
My name is Kaylin Patagan.
I'm Trish Patagan from Money Lake.
This is my first time going for golf in Summer Games.
What did you do before in the Summer Games?
I used to go for ball.
And why did you choose golf over ball this time?
Because I wanted to try something new and I'm kind of getting better on golf.
You just started the last Summer Games.
Yeah.
How did you feel about your performance?
It was good for a beginner.
I proposed it at one of the All Chiefs Conference, Spring Conference, in fact. And my band council had made preparations. I said, you know what we're going to ask for? Well, let's start a Summer Games or Winter Games and see how it'll be acceptable with the FSI. Dave Hennecue was the chief of the FSI at that time, and I got up at the assembly there and I told him that I had a proposal to table with the rest of the chiefs. I said, we see the province, the federal government, having summer games and winter games for all their residents. But we don't see no participants from our reservations, I told him. Well, now we've got to start training our own people. We have our young athletes that are capable, that would be able to slot right in there, compete with the rest of the population. And the Chiefs really went for it, and they made a motion that I pursue and try and get the Summer Games established. The province was the hardest one because they still looked at us as if we were a separate people from the province. And when I started getting the money from the feds and we started planning as to how we were going to spend it, what we had to build, what we had to construct, a lot of preparation had to go into that. Then I started working on the province, and I, that's when I really, really got after them and kept harping. I said, forget that I'm an Indian. I'm coming here as a resident of Saskatchewan. That's what really snapped them into realizing that we were fully residents of Saskatchewan. We got the political support from the Federation that time. The executive were really supportive and whatnot, and they kept harping on the provincial government that we should be getting some kind of a financial assistance to get those games going, and we did. And we kept harping on the fact here that we had to try and keep our communities in shape to try and get them coordinated so they can participate in any form of athletics, recreation, whatever. And they bought that. That was the big seller there, to try and get for them to realize that we wanted to keep our young people in good physical condition.
My name is Alyssa Cashwadam. I am a former athlete of FHQTC, and I am looking at different players because I am the Bantam Assistant Coach of NAG, so I am scouting different players that are up and coming future generations in Team Sask.
Any awesome memories from the Summer Games?
Just mostly the dances that happened out here. Well, that happened at the Summer Games because, I don't know, I'd always get into dance competitions and everything like that. Yeah.
What kind of dancing do you do?
I do pretty much just, well, anything.
Can you show us an example?
Two shuffle.
You can shuffle. All
right,
okay, I have another question for you. Is that how he snagged you?
Well, actually, no. Actually, all I did was just step on her foot.
Really? So it was an accident?
No, it wasn't.
Say hi, PAGC. Oh,
Downs about the center field at number 49, yeah. Julian Byrne.
I am Ashton Burns. I play for PAGC,
And for softball.
My name's Jeremiah Burns, and I play for PAGC softball, and I'm 14 years old.
Our first game we won 9-0, and our second game we just played right now was 17-1.
Jeremy Wiper, 10, Wiper.
Tell us about your favorite part of the summer games.
Having fun and playing with your friends.
Anyone at home that you want to say hi to?
Oh, my grandma and grandpa.
Hi, Dad.
What's your favorite part about the summer games?
Everything.
Like what?
Like fun, friends, sports.
So what was the hardest part about today's game?
Batting.
Did you guys win?
Yeah.
How do you feel about winning?
A taste of victory.
We're here for 2 days. We're here on the Wednesday and Thursday in conjunction with the games. And we're just showcasing a lot of talent, a lot of Juno Award winners, Juno nominees. It's a fun full 2 days of entertainment for all family members.
So first of all, you get your size. I'm a size 7.5. So then you mark it here. You mark it on the other side.
My baby boy is 18 months. You know, with the first pair, you want to make a hole at the bottom of his moccasin. And it keeps, you know, it just keeps you want to, yeah. This is his first pair. And at the bottom of his moccasin, you want to make a hole at the bottom of his moccasin to keep him on a straight and, you know, the red road and a good health, a sober life. You know, and as adults, you know, if that's your first pair, then make that hole at the bottom of your moccasin, say. Like, you know, sometimes as adults, we don't get our first pair until, you know, we're 30 years old.
The other thing I remember here, I went to the games in, the Pheasant Rump. And I watched the games right through, and there are these two young people that came up to me. And this young lady said to me, you know what? She said, my husband and I met at the first summer game, she said. And they had kids participating in Pheasant Rump.
Good afternoon. I'm Simon Moccasin reporting for INCA Online here at Muscadet First Nations for the First Nations Summer Games. Today I am interviewing Tyrell Kakakwe, who is in track and field. Tyrell, how are the games for you?
It's good, it's fun, and I'm having a lot of, you know, fun.
Oh, hey, hold on, bro. You smell that? Who's that? Voila. Here, bro, hold this.
You're still mine, locked in time.
Let's rewind.
Winston Mackay, I'm an elder.
Okay. What tribal council are you representing?
The Cumberland Cree. That would be Woodland. I'm 70 years old, and I've been paddling all my life since I was 10 years old. Paddled 60 years.
Anything you'd like to say to the athletes out there?
I'd like them to keep paddling. Yeah. Yeah, keep trying. Because paddling is officially will be an Olympic sport. It's the hardest sport there is in the world. That's why you don't see too many of them. You use everything. You use your torso, you use your legs, you just everything. Just watch some of these kids, the way, the technique. Paddling is our history. And all our guys from Saskatchewan are good paddlers.
I like competing. Track, 100 meter, 200 meter, and long jump. I got a gold medal in long jump.
From Fall Hills Coppell, Sierra Pro Missins in the junior women's long jump. Those medal presentations are being made by SAS Sport.
Well, what we tell the coaches is to keep the kids hydrated, and actually they should start 2 days before the actual competition so that the kids are well hydrated and keep them hydrated through the competition. And also to make sure that they eat proper meals, not McDonald's, not drive-through junk food, but proper food, especially fruit and vegetables. And then after the race, we encourage them to have bananas and oranges and water ready for the kids to have as soon as they're done the race.
So what do you think of the trade show today?
It's pretty good. It's a really good idea. It helps our youth to dream for the future.
Which out of all of these was your favorite?
So I asked. Because you can go right into working a simulator. It's pretty complicated, actually. It's not like driving a real car. You can't see outside your windows from both directions. You just have to look right at the screen, and that's why it crashed.
It's a great thing, and I know our board is really excited to, you know, to be part of the games, and Muscadet's done a wonderful job in all their partners as well, because it can't happen without, you know, partnerships and resources coming in to an event like this. So we're looking forward to a good week with the kids.
My name's Kiana Cody. I'm 14 years old and I'm from Ojibwe's First Nation.
And what are you playing here today?
I'm playing softball.
And what position do you play?
I'm the pitcher.
Pitcher, and how long have you been pitching for?
4 years.
Is your first summer games here?
No, second. Third actually. My first summer games I was a catcher.
Oh, really?
Yep.
And then what did you do in your second? You pitched?
Pitched.
What kind of stuff you do to get better at pitching?
Well, at home, I ride the bike to get muscle in my legs, and I practice throwing every day. My missum is coming to watch me play, Tony Cody. He's the make starter of the summer games.
And so are you really excited for that?
Yeah, so I hope I win gold for him.
My name is Robert Cody, and I'm just helping coach and Kiana's father.
Melanie Watson, and I'm the coach.
How has your team been doing so far?
I think we've done pretty good. We've had 2 wins so far, both in Mercy Rule, so pretty good.
So what does that do for your girls' team?
Gives them a lot of confidence. They're much more happier on the bench, that kind of thing, so it's good. They're more confident going into the next game.
Some of the girls, they really need to be encouraged because some of them never played at this level before. The kids are young and they enjoy coming to the games. And I played in the games and I coach. Now I'm a parent, and my dad's Tony, and he started the games out. And Cody, you see my hat from, this is original from 78. It's older than my kids.
What's it like going from being a player and now being a coach? What's that like for you guys?
Oh my God, it's an eye-opener. Like, because you come here as an athlete and you really don't know what goes on behind the scenes with planning, where your uniforms come from, that kind of thing. It's an eye-opener for me, I know that.
I think it's pretty good to share your experience because I got about 20 years of ball, and just to help a young ball player come and show them the rules. And like my daughter, I show her pitches and stuff like that. And I think it's really good to give back.
My name's Joseph Tassani, Vice Chief of the Prince Albert Grand Council. Lane is an awesome pitcher, comes from a good family. I don't think you win an event like this by yourself. I think you've got to credit the whole team. I think the coaching and the development, the sports and around the surrounding communities here, I think they're doing an awesome job with softball. So it shows here today. The count was full, and I was just waiting for that right pitch, and that's what he gave me. I just seen the pitch coming and twisted my body, and it was gone. Since Squirt, and we really had a chance to build a bonding there, and we kind of knew what we were going for, and that's what kind of gave us the edge, I think.
Good job, guys.
awesome. It's their final year in the Saskatchewan First Nations Summer Games and a good way to end it. Let's look at the score. I think it's 22-3 over there. Last couple games I seen them develop, and I think they got a long way to go still. I think they're going to remember this for a long time.
I think we all have a responsibility. Our responsibility is that even the ones that are in here, the responsibility of all the chief and council, as well as our better athletes, is to encourage the younger people to pursue, to continue, to develop themselves into a very competitive mode, so they can realize the fact that they can do it. Nala is saying, well, you know, you look, years ago we just used to look at all the professional athletes. Now we have some in the professional games and whatnot, and I would like to see more. What should happen now is that we've been at the games for about 30 odd years plus, that we should select the better athletes and really develop them, because Canada is doing that now for them to participate in the Olympics. They even sponsor them. They look after them. They pay their way down. They pay their way to practice. They have a certain place there where they really develop their athletes. The province and Canada does that, and that's what we've got to do. We should get all those gold medal winners, and we should concentrate on them and further develop them, practice them every day if need be. Then we'll see more of our own people compete in the Olympics. We're going to look back and look at where we were one time, how it developed, how it progressed, and how it's going to progress as we go further and further into the future, because our young people are really going to get involved. Once they see a couple of young people of their own age in the provincial games, in the Olympics or world games, they'll want to be participants as well. And I encourage each and every one of them to do that. And that's where we'll be able to see our own legacy as First Nations people, as Native people, Aboriginal people. That'll be great. We have what we call the NAG Games now, as a result of the Summer Games that we initiated. That's where those come from. I always said, well, we've got to try and encourage other people to participate. Mm-hmm. Now we have the NAG Games, we have athletes coming in from the U.S. competing against our Canadian athletes here. So. And it'll probably expand larger in the future. And I've always maintained the fact there that one of these days that we're going to have a good number of our own athletes participate in the Olympics.